So, because creatively, what I know I can do is I can do certain things. What I didn't want to do is kind of create something entirely false. So I can create a poster, I can make a film, I can do something, but it's all, it's essentially kind of entirely virtual. You know, so I kind of created it. What I was more interested in doing was they're saying if you've got a teenager who's being bullied, who's really suffering, and then they lock themselves away in their bedroom, and their bedroom becomes like sort of solace, but it also becomes that space where feelings can quickly run away from themselves, run away with themselves, and that sort of, you know, so what does it mean to be that child in that environment? So if we can help parents understand what a child can kind of go through when they're left their own devices and they sort of overthink things, what does that process? So we can place them in a child's room, this is what your child feels when they're in this particular space, this is how it affects them, sort of bring that to life visually through sound. And kind of do it in a creative way, but do it in a way which is designed to be a little bit more contextual to the individual.
I saw on the news someone was using something like this in painting, and they were showing people visually, like someone had bipolar, and this is like how it affects me. Is this what this?
Yeah, I haven't seen that particular demo, but
that was about a week ago.
Yeah, once you see this, it might make sense.
So yeah, and if I just start from the beginning. So Windows 10 device, we build apps for it just like what's called the Universal Windows Platform. So we build an app just like for Windows 10 or for the Xbox, but we build it for the HoloLens, so these things can be all sort of slightly interchangeable. So we can build a 2D interface for Windows 10 and very quickly bundle it up and put it onto here to make it accessible. So this is running Cortana, so it's got voice activation on there, it's got some Microsoft Edge as a browser, so those things, and it's also got lots of cool, obviously, proper holographic applications. So if I just start off with showing you some, maybe just standard holograms. So a lot of the gestures are quite simple. There's there's the blue gesture, which opens up the panel in front of me, like that. You might be getting a bit late. And I can navigate this with what's called an air tap, using my finger going down. Right, selecting that particular app there, my air tap it to load up. And I can look around, decide where I'm going to place it. So what's cool about this as well, it's completely aware of the environment. This is a bit of my favorite bit. If I just do that, you'll see that. So if you see it, where it goes up over that chair. So it's already in real time. It's got like loads of kind of IR sensors. It's a bit like the Kinect. Microsoft Kinect box. It's doing real-time mapping, data mapping of the whole environment, scanning it all in real-time and working and creating this 3D mesh that you can see there. You can see how it's going over things and knows where people are and that object. So it then it's able to build that model of the environment that you're in and be able to then use that and contextualize that. So if I build an app with a ball, for example, I could throw a ball, put it onto the table, and throw it back, just click it and drag it. And it would bounce on the table and be able to roll off the table as opposed to where the edge of that table is. So you can see it goes down there, you've got that table and where the floor is and what's different. So that's quite cool. Let's go back to holograms quickly, and I'll just open up one of these guys, like Spaceman's my favourite. So I've got Spaceman over here. I'm going to adjust him and bring him out and make him a little bigger. Too big. Done. As you can see, I can walk around. He's completely locked in space. I can see him from all angles. Yeah, even if I was to come underneath him and see him like that. So, probably need someone else to just jump in at this point to have a go. So, just quickly put some other holograms up, and I'll hand over to you guys.
It's like
warming
on acid, isn't it?
I don't know what was in that coffee on Thursday. 3 cups of coffee.
I feel like it was in
the
speed.
I'm
on Thursday.
I've done this in the pub once. In a public space, and I got some very strange looks.
So you know your question about sort of Alexa.